I was toting my pack along the dusty Winnemucca road, when along came a semi with a high-end canvas-covered load. If you're going to Winnemucca, Mac, with me you can ride. And so I climbed into the cab and then I settled down inside. He asked me if I'd seen a road with so much dust and sand, and I said, listen, I've traveled every road in this here land.
Hey guys, gals, Teddy here at Spinwurkz, 1997 Ural sidecar. What a cool piece. Got that military feel. This is Russian made Ural. I've had the Russians correct me, it's Ural. So however you want to pronounce it, this is a Russian made sidecar. Bring that camera on, guys. Let's check it out. One owner bike, 520 kilometers, not miles, kilometers, 520. Ultra, ultra low. We're going to start from the top. We'll work our way down as we usually do. Gas tank does have a little ding on the top. I'm going to zoom in. I want you guys to see that. It's like someone pushed it in. It might be able to get pulled back out. It's very minor. But I do want to be transparent so that you guys know that. It's going to have your headlight up front. Turn signals are going to be on the left side of the motorcycle and the right side of the sidecar. This is going to have a gigantic presence on the road. You're talking 6 feet wide of motorcycle. You're going to have lights on the front and the back of the sidecar wheel, as well as the brake light and your left turn signal on the back of the motorcycle. This is going to have that same feel at night as a car. Lots and lots of room here. Big, big, big bike, all steel. So it definitely brings that safety factor that I love about sidecars. It's going to be safe, safe, safe. Let's go ahead and we'll come back here, guys. Track your seats, check them out. This is what dates the bike, brings it all the way back into the 40s when they moved those Russian troops back from Germany invading. This is what it was used to move through the Ural Mountains. The tractor seats, one of my favorite pieces you'll find on a Ural, dates them, and don't get this messed up, guys. These things are unbelievably comfortable. Definitely a big improvement for any Ural. Go ahead and check out the reviews online from people that buy them. That single pylon seat versus the tractor seats, second to none. Super comfortable, and they do make gel covers for these if you want to put a little bit of extra padding on here. My personal preference, I like to do them just like you see here. A couple reasons why. One, they're comfortable enough for me. I'm 6'5", I'm a big guy, 200 plus pounds. And I get on this, I feel right at home. Also, when you're off-roading on these, you get water or mud on here, it flies right off because it's a rubber seat. Pretty cool. This is gonna have the off-road tire package on it. This is the most extreme tire package you can get for a Ural. Check out the knobs and lugs on these tires, guys. We'll make sure the camera zooms in, you get to see those. Does have a tonneau cover on the sidecar. Go ahead and we'll pull it back so you guys can check it out. This, you can remove the tonneau cover completely. There's a wonderful thick padded seat in here. Looks like it was freshly skinned maybe a year ago or so. Still in really good condition. Trunk on this, guys. Take a look. Storage for days. You have tons and tons of space back here. There's a strap that you'll see that stops the trunk from opening and coming back around on itself. So it's got a safety in line there. It does have the jerry can up front on the sidecar. And check this out. That's the spout for the jerry can. That's included as well, guys. Pretty cool. There's a tool kit in here. There's also a tire pump and some other assorted tools that are going to be included in the sale on this. All right, go ahead and close that up. Other than that, guys, you're going to see the storage bag on the outside of the jerry can, as well as just a few other accessories you'll see on here. There's not a ton of accessories on it as far as the Ural goes, but you will see that on our website, if you want to click around or even call us, the number's on the screen there, guys, you'll see the amount of accessories for this bike is astounding. They make the machine gun mount. They make the winch. There's tons and tons of accessories on here. We're going to go ahead and do a sound test on this, guys. I'm going to turn the bike around. We'll be right back. Jacksonville, Waterville, Coastal, Rhino, Pittsfield, Springfield, Bakersfield, Shreveport, Hackensack, Cadillac, Fond du Lac, Davenport, Idaho, Jellicoe, Argentina, Diamantina, Pasadena, Catalina. Here's going to be a sound test, guys. This is a 1997 Ural. This is going to be the kickstart. There's a little bit of a process to start this. There's a prime button on the carb right here. What that will do is bring a little more fuel into the carburetor. Switch is on. Kickstart's right here. Make sure your engine kill switch is in the right place. And ignition. There we go. It is carbureted, so you want to let it warm up for a little bit. But the sound on these pipes, it's dual exhaust. Got a pretty nice sound. bad for 97. That's beautiful. Again, guys, if you're looking to get into a piece of history, what better way to do it than on a vintage-looking sidecar? This is the Ural. It's a 97. Super, super low mileage on this. If you guys have any questions, numbers on the screen, website's on the other side. So if you guys want to reach out, talk to Drew or myself, be happy to help you out. Thank you for watching. God bless, and ride safe.